Hello students, this is the last concept of this chapter as we have already finished so many topics and this is the last one that is left. So this is the nervous tissue. In the previous video we discussed about this muscular tissue and this one is left, this is nervous tissue. So what do you mean by nervous tissue? Any idea? Can you tell me any idea? Do you have any ideas about this nervous tissue? In class 8 also you got about this neuron and nerve cells. Can you remember this one? So neuron and nerve cells, neuron or nerve cell is the most fundamental unit of this nervous system. We have in our body different systems are there, like digestive system, respiratory system, musculoskeletal system. Different systems are there in our body. Among them one is there, that is nervous system, which is responsible for carrying messages from one part of the body to another part. Like different parts are there in our body, like we have brain. So our brain is sending information to various parts to do various functions. So that information which is sent by our brain is carried by the nervous system. Nervous system is carrying the information from brain, or not only from brain, from different parts of the body, from one part of the body to another part. Like we are kicking a ball, so our brain is instructing our leg or feet to kick the ball. So that information from the brain is sending to the leg via this neuron or nerve cells. So this nervous system is acting on this. So similarly, so many functions are there. So all these functions are, so the information for these functions are being carried out by this nervous system. So our nervous system is made up of these nervous tissues, and nervous tissue is composed of specialized cells called nerve cells. So nervous tissue is composed of some specialized cells called nerve cells. So nerve cells are also known as neurons. So don't get confused about this neuron and nerve cell. So both the things are same. Neurons are also called as nerve cells. So neurons are a structural and functional unit of nervous system. So the nervous system that we have in our body is in the functional and structural unit of this nervous system is nothing but this neuron. So neuron constitute the nervous system as well as it performs all the functions of the nervous system. So if we talk about the structure of neuron, we see that neuron is the structural and functional unit of the nervous system, and neuron has many parts, and out of these three main parts are there. Mainly we can divide the neuron into three main parts. So what are the parts? These are dendrite, cell body, which is also known as soma, so cell, and axon. So cell body is also known as soma, and we have this dendrite and axon. So mainly we can divide into these three categories. So besides this, some other parts are there, but these are the main three things. So if you see this picture, this is the structure of a neuron. So here this branched structure is known as dendrite. So these branch structures are known as dendrite, and here we have a nucleus. It is a cell, so it means it will have a nucleus, definitely. There is no doubt in that. So nucleus is there, and around the nucleus we have a free space. This is a space, and this is known as cell body or soma. And we have a long cylinder like structure, and that is known as axon. So from here to here, this and inside this blue one are long fiber like long stretch one line is there, that is known as axon. And axon is covered with this, with the help of this myelin sheath. So different, you can see some bubbles like this things. So these things are covers this axon, and they are known as myelin sheath. So depending upon the presence of this myelin sheath, we can divide the neurons into two types, that is myelinated neuron and non-myelinated neuron. So about this one we will be discussing class 11. In this class 9 we don't have that much. So we only discuss about the axon here. We will not consider as myelin sheath enough. And at the end, we have again this axon is getting branched, and this is known as axon terminal. The end neuron is getting end here. So this is known as an axon terminal or nerve ending also, you can say this one. So this is the structure of the neuron or nerve cell. So this is the direction of electrical impulse. This is the main function of this neuron. As we know that the main function of nervous system is to carry information from one part of the body to another part. So how does this information is being carried out? So if you see here, So what are the information is being sent by the one part that is considered here we have brain. The brain is sending one information. That information will be accepted by this dendrite. So here we have the dendrite. The dendrite will accept the information which is being sent by the other part. And from the dendrite, it will be sent to this cell body or soma. So from dendrite, the information is coming to this cell body. And from cell body, what happens? The information is going like this. So it will go through this axon to ultimately it will reaches to the nerve ending. So the information is accepted by the dendrite, and from dendrite it is sent to the cell body or soma, and from soma through axon it is reached, it is being reached to the axon terminal. So this is the flow of the direction of electrical impulse, that information. So information is sent like this from dendrite to axon terminal via this soma and this axon. So this is the main function of this nervous system or the neuron. So if you discuss the function of neuron, so we have different parts of the neuron. So we will be discussing what are the function of each part. So first we will consider the dendrite. So what is the function of dendrite? It receives, as I have already mentioned, that dendrite receives information from the receptors and conducts the messages towards the cell body. So that information from the receptor or from any part will be accepted by this dendrite. So dendrite will receive the information, and from dendrite it will conduct the messages towards the cell body. So it will be sending towards the cell body. And what is the function of cell body then? The cell body and the nucleus do not play any active role. Mark it here. So the cell body and nucleus do not play any active role in transmission of the neural signal. So they do not play any active role in this sending of the neural signal or information. So they do not take part in the actively in this transmission of neural signals. Instead, these two structures serve to maintain the cell and keep the neuron functional. So their main function, the cell body and nucleus, they kind of maintain the cell and keep the neuron functional. So that is their main function. They do not play any active role in this transmission of messages. And what is the function of axon? It conducts messages away from the cell body. So what is the information which is being sent from the dendrite to the cell body? So that information will be conducts away or taken away by this axon from the cell body towards the nerve ending or towards the axon terminal. So these are the different functions of different parts. So up to this much I hope clear. If you have any confusion, any doubt, you can ask me. And this was a very short description about this nervous system or nervous tissue. With this one we have completed the chapter. And some exercise questions are there. You try to answer this by your own. If you find any difficulty or any problem, you can ask me. I am here to help you. And thank you for watching the video once again.